work at Texas A&M. One runs the Galveston campus, and three are professors here on campus. And it is a tremendous change from being at NASA for 30 years, but it's something that I've always wanted to do. That's why I finished up my doctorate, and I have students in my class all the time. In fact, while I was waiting to come up here, I was answering one of my students' homework questions for them. So it's a different career, but I'm very blessed to have the opportunity to be here in College Station. What I'd like to do today is to talk to you about the International Space Station. If you go out in the night sky when it's not overcast, the ISS is passing overhead, you'll be able to see it for about 4 to 5 minutes, typically. It's moving pretty fast, 17,500 miles an hour, so you won't see it for long. But it all started back in 1998, and I was really blessed to be on that first mission. The chief of the astronaut office selected himself to command the mission. That was kind of tradition, that the chief of the astronaut office always selects themselves for the really, really good missions. We always say in the astronaut office that there's no such thing as a bad mission. Some are a little better than others, and I was would definitely put this mission in that category, because we were the ones for the first time to power up the space station in its infancy, turn on the lights, and make the first call, Houston, this is the International Space Station. And what I always tell kids is that that's sort of my moon landing. My class patch, which is here, class of 1990, has the moon and Mars on it. At the time, the first President Bush said, in the next 10 years, we're going to go back to the moon and on to Mars. And our class said, wow, that's fantastic. We're going to get to go do that. Well, we're still waiting. Hopefully, we will do that. And at the end, I'm going to leave some time for questions. But I do want to touch on at the very end about why I think we're not quite ready for a mission to Mars right now. And I will tell you, it's because of the unknowns and the effects of space on human physiology. And we're learning, as crew members come back from 6 month and 1 year long stays on the space station, there are some degrading effects to their health that potentially are for their lifetime.